A Kanban board is a project management tool designed to help you visualize your work using cards, columns, and specific commitment and delivery points to help you understand how your work flows so you can get your work done. I'm Max, a PMM on Jira software, and I manage all of my projects with a Kanban board. In fact, this video series is managed on a Kanban board. In a lot of ways, if you're watching this video on the internet right now, Kanban boards work. We're going to start our discussion talking about the elements of a Kanban board. Basically, what you should have on your board to make sure it helps you manage your work. Now, there are two philosophies about this. The first is by David Anderson, who popularized the Kanban method. The Kanban method is largely responsible for taking Kanban from a manufacturing process into software. And David Anderson defines five key elements of a Kanban board. One of the first things you'll notice about a Kanban board are the visual signals, cards, stickies, tickets, or otherwise. Kanban teams write all of their work items onto cards, usually one item per card. For agile software teams, you can think of these as one user story per card. Cards help teammates and stakeholders get a glance at what everyone is working on at one time. Another hallmark of the Kanban board are the columns. Columns represent a specific activity that together compose a workflow. Cards flow through the workflow until completion. Workflows can be as simple as to do, in progress, and done, or much more complex. Two important components of a workflow are the commitment point and the delivery point. Kanban teams often have a backlog for their board, where customers and teammates put ideas for new projects that the team can pick up. The commitment point is the moment when a team picks up one of those projects and work begins. The delivery point is the end of a Kanban team's workflow. For most teams, this is when the product or service is in the hands of the customer or done. The time that it takes to get from the commitment point to the delivery point is called lead time. Lastly, WIP limits. WIP, or work in progress limits, are simple mechanisms to limit the number of cards in any one column at any one time. Kanban teams find that by limiting work in progress, they actually move projects through the board in a more timely manner. Those five components, as described by David Anderson, are more than enough to manage the flow of work with a Kanban board. There's another philosophy, however, that's much simpler. Let's walk. The second philosophy is Personal Kanban by Jim Benson and Tony Ann DiMaria. In Personal Kanban, there are only two rules: visualize your work and limit work in progress. And you can do this however you see fit. Personal Kanban is great for boards that maybe only you contribute to, or a small team with a simple workflow. The simplest Kanban boards are physical boards where teams divide their workflow into vertical columns. They take a whiteboard or a blackboard and they mark up the board, filling each column with sticky notes. The sticky notes then flow through the workflow to demonstrate progress. The first advantage of a physical board is it's super easy to set up. The second reason that I love physical boards is they're so tangible and fun. Kanban helps you visualize your work, and there's something about this colored sticky note and moving it from one column to the other that is so motivating and easy to engage with. If you're starting to visualize your work, you might as well start with a physical board. Digital boards are preferable for a whole host of reasons. The first is that if your team is remote or distributed or just not all in the same building, then you really want to have a digital board. You want everyone to have equal access to the information and be able to access it from anywhere. Second is that digital boards are just plain fast. If you've ever used Jira or Trello, you know that you can create boards and columns and cards in seconds. Lastly, digital boards like Jira come complete with all the data and information you need to make informed decisions about how your team is working. While it's not impossible with physical boards, being able to analyze WIP, cumulative flow diagrams, cycle time, and many more with just a click or two is a huge advantage over physical boards. Those are the key things you want to look for in a digital board. We've included a link in the description for a tutorial of how to make your first board in Jira software. My mentor, Zach Neese, gave me great advice for how teams should get started with Kanban boards. He shared that teams should start with a physical board, built on a whiteboard or a window, with Sharpies and pens and sticky notes. This physical board is going to be a great conversation starter. People will walk up to the board and look at it and start these conversations about how you work, about how you write these cards, about how you move work through these columns. These early conversations are going to lead to some changes in your workflow, and those changes are essential to getting Kanban right. Once you understand how your work flows, you're ready to graduate to a digital tool like Trello or Jira. These tools are going to help you measure your progress, and you'll be able to share your workflow with people outside of your immediate location. And when you're ready to do that, we can help.